Hello Wabasatan, welcome to my show for the gays, and I'm very happy to meet you. I wish it always to meet you.
Thank you.
I want you to tell me about your life when you lived in Syria. You had a bad situation there. How did you live there? You came to America when you were an older.
That's right. I lived in a Syria, very bad situation. I lived as a man. I mean, I was a man. And when I come to the USA, I transformed myself from male to female. That's the point why I live in USA. And now I'm happy.
Wait. Are you telling me that you were male when you lived in Syria and you transformed to a female? Oh, that's impossible. How did you do that?
Yes, I was a man. But I was not other men. I was very ugly man, and I looked like an ape, like gorilla. I was hairy man. My body covered hair, and I was stinky man. No girl wanted to me. I loved a girl, and she said to me, "How can I love an ape man? You are not a human."
So that's why you changed your gender, because you
were
an ape.
Yes, that's why I changed my gender. I ask people what country can I live if Syria don't like me. And after some Shia calls their service Nusayriya raped me. And I was very unhappy. That's why I lived from Syria to USA.
But you are an ape and no one likes you. So why did they rape you? If they rape you, it's just like they rape an ape.
You know Shia are nothing. They are like animal. They are like Christian. They can do everything. They are pedophiles. They rape everything they met. Even ape men, they rape. How do you think some people who can rape an ape man and stink?
That is very sad. So you live all your life there, sadness,
yes.
Happiness.
Yes. But now, no, I am little happy. What do you think? I think I am little beautiful than before. Because before I look like an ape and not human. But now I have money, I am famous, and I am very happy.
And so what do you think? You are in the gay community. How do you feel there, as long as you are the president in there?
Yes, I am very happy because all the gays love me, all the pedophiles, all the lesbians. You know, call them, all of them, gay community. Now I am the chief of gay community. So they love me.
What about, you know, your best friend, I hear, Ayan Hirsi? She was also a
transgender. Yes, I know her. She is black Dutch. She is a transgender like me. And you know Salman Rushdie, he is a dark, dirty colored British Indian. And he is transformed like me.
Wow, that's very impossible. I never heard that. So how do you feel now? As long as you're living in USA, don't you see something troubles on there? A lot of Muslims who live there. So tell me.
Yes, but I have
Wait. You are in bad situation now. There are a lot, millions of Muslims in America. What if one of them can be your bodyguard and kill you one day? Aren't you afraid of that? Because you have wrote many things bad things about
but
Islam.
I am not the only one who is gays and who is anti-religion. There are many people like me, like my situation. Like Ayan Hirsi, Salman Rushdie, they had got bodyguards like me. But in USA, everywhere is security. And I'm not afraid. I live a good situation than before.
Okay.
So I'm not afraid. But I would like, if I meet some Muslims, I would like to tell them why those Shia who call themselves that they are Islam, why they rape an ape man? That's the question I every.
So, that's you weren't famous, so you became famous.
Yes,
you
I became famous.
Islam.
Yeah, you know I wanted to be a famous, but I say what thing can I be a famous? I can't be an actor.
You can insult Islam. That's why you felt you can be a famous. Because Ayan Hirsi, Salman Rushdie, all of them, they insult Islam and they become famous. Like the one the Dutch man, what did you call his name? I forgot what was his name that made the movie Fitna. He wasn't famous when he insulted Islam. He became one second famous, like the Benedict. That Pope, no one liked him, no one cared about him. But
yes, I know all of them. All of them are anti-Islam. I am anti-Islam too. But ask me my life when I was living in Syria. How could I get money to come in America? I want to tell all the people.
Tell me that. How did you came America? Where did you get money? And because you took a flight, weren't people afraid of you? You were an ape. So if there you can't change your body because it's a poor country and no one can make you a female or cut your hair or like this. It's too much, right? So tell me more, please. I wanted to know more about your life.
I was very poor man and my father was rich and he hated me. I was very poor man and my father was rich and he hated me. But one day he do favor to me.
Why did your father hate you? Did you do something bad, father?
No, I was very bad. All the people hated me. Even my mother hates me. My brothers hate me. All the country hate me. People throw to me to stones, and they would like to kill me.
But I wanted a reason. I want you to tell me why they did hate you. Did you do something bad? You know, people just can't hate you like that. They must hate you until you do something bad. If you did you kill something, did you rape, or did you use cocaine? Just like that, your father will hate you. He wanted you to become a good boy, right? So please tell me, why did your father hate you?
I was not only the ape man and the ugly man. I was killer. I was bad boy. I was raper. One day I raped a little girl who was only 3 years old. I was very bad. I think this is a punish from God because I was anti-religion. I became transgender. That's why. That's all my biography. No.
Thank you, Wabasa.
You're welcome.
Thank you for coming. And that was Wabasa Satan, who transformed herself from male to female. And I'm going to show a picture from her when she was a male. And now take a look how she looked like a monkey. Isn't that sad?